Hello there. Welcome back. We are doing another car video. It's been a minute. Spent most of December and partly November just doing wedding plans from the video last week that you saw. So now we're back to pimp my ride. Today we're going to be checking on the Mini Cooper. I ran into a couple issues with the Mini Cooper in November. Like, you know how they say just before a wedding a lot of things start going wrong? Every time you drive this car over 140, the rear back tire would throw codes of tire pressure as if it's low or something, and it does seem like it has a slow puncture. So we're gonna check that out today. And then also we had a water problem with the car. I don't know what was happening, but it kept consuming a lot of water and I had no cooking clue why, but now it seems to be stable. What we did was I called my mechanic, the one who usually works on the Mini Cooper, and I asked him what I should do before I have to actually come to him and fix the car. And what he told me is to bleed the system, or to get all the air bubbles out of it. So basically what you do is, actually, wait. Let me speed this up. I will show you once I pop the hood. Now that this is open, right? So this is the overflow tank that was going mad. So what we did was we opened it, and then there was a funnel that went maybe this high, and it was quite wide, and we poured water in it, and we waited for it to bubble until it was done. Now, from what he told me, it shouldn't bubble for too long. So if it bubbles maybe 15-20 minutes in, then it's either the water pump or the head gasket. But because it bubbled for about 10 minutes and then it stopped, and then it seemed as if now it was running at a normal temp, then it was fine. We then switched off the car and we waited to see the next morning if there'd be water on the floor or anything of those sorts. But the engine seemed 100%. So yeah, now my biggest problem is this tire, because now every time we drive, it always, we pump it, and then as soon as you exceed 140 kilometers or so, it goes into fighting mode and it says tire pressure low and etc. So I'm gonna jack the car up, take it out, and do a proper pressure test so we can see, with a bucket of water of course, so we can see exactly where the problem is on this tire. I'm kind of praying it's not the rim, because if it's the rim, we're seeing real problems. So guys, I've used all the methods that I know to check how or if the rim or the tire is leaking, and nothing is popping up. I don't know what could possibly be the problem here. But yeah, it's quite complicated now. I'm gonna pump it one last time and see if it will lose pressure. Then we'll have to go to a shop and have them check it out. Okay, please don't judge the gas situation. I'm now gonna pull the car into the garage, because there is a light bulb that I think it's finished or it doesn't want to cooperate. So I think I'm gonna take that light bulb out and switch that one and see what happens, and then we wrap up the video. So I'm now in the garage. I just want to give you a quick walkthrough as to what's going on with this light bulb. It kind of looks funny when we drive in from another perspective.
So as you can see, the half one is on here, but this one is dead at the top. So yeah, let's get started quick.
So according to the Mini Cooper manual, you need to turn the wheel full lock to the opposite way as if it's turning, and then it will grant you access to be able to access. Oh, there we go. Let's see. There we go. It will grant you access to the inside once you pull that cover off. As you can see, there's two. There's one on the bottom right here, and then there's one at the top over there. I'm going to be changing the top one because that's the bulb we're going for, and we should see what happens. Just a quick note, if anybody wants to know, I buy all of my bulbs and parts from BMO Spares in Pretoria. And I want to say it's Pretoria West, but it's more central as well. You just go with the blown one and you show them how it looks, and then they give you a replica. These bulbs generally cost 10 rand or 15 rand for one. It's really not that expensive. Yeah, so let's get to it. Guys, I messed up. Gonna have to continue this video another week. The bulb was too small, so before I pulled it out, I checked the size of this bulb right here and the one just underneath it. This one is very small, so I guess we're gonna have to go and find a bulb of this size first. There's no use of pulling it out right now because this bulb is relatively smaller than the one I have. Yeah, so gonna end the video right here. Catch you guys next week. What's up, everybody? I just realized I didn't close the video yesterday. So I took a lot of L's yesterday. I tried to fix the tire. I failed at that. I did not find where the slow puncher was coming from. I tried to change the globe and I had the wrong size. That's also another reason why I made this channel, is to show that in the process of modifying a car, even for an amateur, I have no background around vehicles. I do have a background around vehicles, but I don't have a background in terms of, I haven't studied engineering of any sort or any mechanical motor, whatever you want to call it. But I took a lot of L's yesterday, and in the process of modifying a vehicle, that is also another reason why I built this channel. Majority of times you see only the nice parts, only the fun times. There is days that you take L's, there is months sometimes that you'll take an L, and that's what I want to share with you guys. And it's all not always sunshine and roses. But then again, I just want to thank you guys for watching. Thank you for subscribing. For those that haven't subscribed, please do that. And as from next year, we're making some dramatic changes to this channel. It will still be car related. It's just a few things are going to change. Yeah, thank you for watching. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace out.